hockey fans, and welcome to Hockey Town Central, as we're here for play-by-play's coverage of the Little Caesars Squirt AA Norris Championship here on March 14th, 2008. Boy, we got a couple of great combatants, actually a rematch, I believe. Your Oakland Junior Grizzlies going up against the Suburban Stars. My name is Rance Ford. I'll be calling all the action for you here today. Let's get you introduced to both of these squads. First, for your Junior Grizzlies, Brendan Boncour will be between the pipes, and he wears number one on the Grizzly sweater. Jack Venuto is working on defense. He's wearing number seven. And look for Austin Levering over on the right wing side, wearing number nine for your Grizzlies. Joey Savelle is working at center. He wears number 10 on the uniform. And double uno, that's number 11. That's right winger Nick Blankenberg. Tommy Theo Harris is over on the right wing as well. He wears an even dozen on the sweater. And Connor Jean dares to wear that number 13, and he'll be working at the left wing side. Also on left wing is big Connor Inger. And Connor wearing number 18 for your Junior Grizzlies. We got some more of the big bears to bring you. If our man in the truck will hit the video magical mix master, there he goes. And number 19, my favorite hockey number, being worn by Max Jones. And he's even at the right position, skating at center for the Junior Grizzlies. Watch out for Marino Merlini, anchoring the defense, wearing 24 and 33. That's William Vanderveen, also working back on the blue line. Double four is being worn by Robbie Flannery, who skates on defense. And double nickels, 55, is Blake Avenue, and he'll be working on defense as well. Last, certainly not least, is big Garrett Hall. He's on the left wing side, and he wears number 87 for your Oakland Junior Grizzlies. And boy, what a coaching staff we've got for these Oakland Junior Grizzlies. Here's your head coach, Brad Jones, former NHL player, I believe, helped out by Rob Flannery, Andrew Boncour, and Joe Savelle. And your manager is the incomparable Rick Merlini. Now waddling to the microphone to get you introduced to those Suburban Stars. Here he is, folks. The legend of large, the myth of mass, the fable of fat, the hippo of hockey, ex-Canadian goaltender, and your color commentator today, Bronco Bobby Wawa.
Well, thank you there, partner. It's time to introduce you to those Suburban Stars. Wearing number one in goal, it's Spencer Applebaum. And they have another great goaltender that will be wearing number 34 today. And that's Sam Wasnicki. On defense, wearing those two big zeros today, Tyler Sensky. On defense, the great skater that wears number three, it's Nick Boca. At center, wearing number four today, will be Eric Marson. Bryce Becker on defense, wearing number five. Wearing number eight, it's going to be Austin Elger. And he'll be skating at right wing. Wearing number 10 at center, it's Danny McGrail. A squad to be reckoned with. The Suburban Stars have had a fantastic season, fans, and they're capitalizing on this today because, you know what, they want to win this thing bad. And we're at right wing, wearing number 13, it's Austin Bottrell. At left wing, wearing number 14 today, it's Colin Juszczyk. At right wing, one of the toughest skaters around, wearing number 15, it's Drew Anastas. At left wing today, wearing number 19, it's Dylan Jones. Kyle McCullough at center, wearing number 21. At left wing, it's Joey Orr, and he's wearing number 24. On defense, wearing that 77 today, it's Luke Krasicki. A squad here. What a great lineup they have here this afternoon, and it's fitting that they would be here for championship hockey. And here's part of the reason why they're there. Look at who their head coach is, and that's Joe Jones is here this afternoon, assisted by one of the best, Gary Becker. Tom Anastos assists also, along with Michael McCullough, Kevin Alger, and look at who your managers are. The beautiful twin managing team, the tag team, Susan Bottrell and Terry Krasicki. a squad here that hits the ice. And watch that first step, fans.
Here come your Oakland Junior Grizzlies. And we have had seen many teams have trouble with that first step. The Grizzlies in the black and white. Bronco got some gold trim on there, I think.
Yeah, turn that sign around so we can. There you go. Let's go, Grizzlies.
Crush them, number 10.
Yeah, look at them. They're really into
Joey
this.
Joey Sardell's fan club up there for blood, Bronco.
Yep, I see Grandma and Grandpa's up there. They're all here this afternoon.
Here come the Suburban Stars. As we said, I think both of these teams played against each other last year under different team names, so it's a rematch here we got going in the Squirt AA Norris Championship.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure why teams change their names like that, but we've seen that often. Happen quite often. Go 13 Stars!
Number 13, the Austin Betrell fan club being represented right there, it looks like. In double zeros, Tyler Senske's president of his fan club right there, Bronco.
Boy, some beautiful, beautiful posters here this afternoon. A lot of enthusiasm in the crowd. I was signing autographs in the lobby before this one got underway here today, and what a great one.
Oh, we got two good teams out on the Hockey Town ice. As you see, the Junior Grizzlies getting warmed up. We got signs and banners.
Grizzlies are great. Sounds like that cereal. What was the tiger on it?
Oh, come on, Tony the Tiger. You must remember that.
Yeah, there we go.
We got noisemakers. We've got everything. We've got a lot of happy hockey moms, it looks like, up there, Bronco.
And something with hockey moms. How come they're all so pretty?
Yeah, I don't know. It just works out that way, I guess. Spencer Applebaum and Sam Wozniacki. Getting warmed up for your Suburban Stars. As Spencer Applebaum expected to get the start.
Some of the cast from West Side Story here.
There you go. Stay cool, boy.
Yeah, they look like they're ready to go. Well, look at the
another
sweatshirts.
Star side. Look at the young lady's got the face all painted and everything else, Bronco.
Yep, I really like their sweatshirts they have this year and the color on the posters. Just beautiful.
Head coach Joe Jones is going to have some final words with his Suburban Stars before we get the drop of the puck here to get this Squirt AA Norris Championship going. Brendan Boncour, the only one dressed in the goalie pads for your Oakland Junior Grizzlies. He puts the water bottle on the back of the net. If that was Bronco, that'd be a ketchup and mustard bottle.
Yep, and a George Foreman grill.
That's right. He'd have it all up back there compared to Dine as he plays goaltender. We're underway here with the first period of play as it's brought in by the Junior Grizzlies on the far side.
Fires
send
away.
The shot right on, and Spencer Applebaum has to make the quick save. Garrett Hall with the opportunity jumping right out of the faceoff circle. The Junior Grizzlies.
Some quick skating here. Good maneuvering.
Grail send a shot. Big rebound shot and score.
Gets that rebound shot in there right away, and we have our first score.
Garrett Hall the rebound and sends it past Applebaum as Danny McGrail turned it right back in. He'll pick up an assist on the play, and less than a minute into this hockey game, the Oakland Junior Grizzlies get the claws out and scratch the Stars, Bronco.
Yeah, they make a statement early here with some super skating. We're going to slow it down so you can watch how he maneuvers around the puck, passes it off there. We've got the rebound, and guess who's waiting?
Right there is 87. Garrett Hall plunks it past the Applebaum. Original shot coming from Joey Savelle. He'll pick up an assist on the play. So that quick is 23 seconds into this hockey game. The Oakland Junior Grizzlies put the Stars on notice, Bronco.
You want to do that if you can. You want to score very early to try to take the momentum. But the Suburban Stars, you know, they're used to playing in tough games, and they'll come right back at you.
That's right. The Suburban Stars tried to squeeze along the boards, but getting a stick on it was Hall. He got it to number 10, Savelle, who sends the shot, tried to go five-hole. Nice stop for Applebaum, but the big rebound was there, and he couldn't get back to track down that shot by Garrett Hall as he lifted it into the rafters, Bronco.
Yeah, Garrett was waiting right there, and he didn't hesitate when he saw that rebound came out. He put it in, did what he had to do, and we have our first score.
11:37 left to go in this first period of play. Garrett Hall's favorite food is Mexican. His favorite hockey player is Sidney Crosby. Well, I used to like him. His favorite movie is Miracle, and he would like to mention that his sister, Paige, always makes both games and practices to show her support for her brother.
Well, that's good.
Garrett practices in the basement with his dog, Maggie, who plays defense on the forum, I guess. And he loves playing with his line mate, Nikki, who's Garrett's dad refers to as Gilligan and the Skipper.
Well, we don't remember that old program, Gilligan's Island.
Well, I do anyway. This is picked up by Alger, trying to work out through center ice for his Suburban Stars. He's knocked off the puck, getting a stick on it there, Eric Marson. And here's the big man, double zero, Tyler Senske, bringing it up. He'll fire the shot right on. Big rebound swept out of there by the Grizzlies, but the Stars hold it in. Boy, number double zero is a big man, Tyler Senske, coming down that ice for the Stars.
Tyler's favorite food are pears. The most important pregame habit, warm-up and eating a Hershey bar. The hardest shot on the team, and can't wait to slap shot and check. Bryce has a real problem with smell coming from his bag. Can solve a Rubik's Cube, though.
Oh, you must like that, his warm-up routine.
That sounds good. I love Hershey bars.
Of course, Bronco used to eat four whole chickens in his warm-up.
Yeah, you got to have those.
And Senske behind the net once again. Mr. Sense will throw it right up the left wing side. Collected there by Marson. Works his way in, but getting back to take it off of his stick. Connor Jean moves around behind Boncour. Looking to send it back out. This will get back out to center ice. Look out for the speed of Connor Jean out there. Actually, Connor's a star running back playing football, and he plays hockey just like he plays football, says his manager. Here comes number 13, Batrell for the Stars coming in, and looks like number 33, Vanderveen, spoiled that shot. Ends up in behind the cage. 13 gets it again, sends it out front, but it's intercepted by your Grizzlies. And the Grizzlies will throw the long pass on the right wing side for Theo Harris. Firing right on, and Applebaum's to that side. Shot back on, and that looked like it hit the side of the net. As it comes back along the near side, here come your Suburban Stars again, but it'll be the Junior Grizzlies to collect it back in their own zone. Send it right into your living room where it's picked up by Gene. Gene gets the backhand ahead, and Savelle can't catch up with it. Reach back for Gene, picking it up off the boards. Is Nick Bulk out there in front of him. Back come your Stars looking for a chance. Ooh, trying to sweep the shot in. Danny McGrail, but the Grizzlies spoiled that.
Well, Danny's most important pregame habit is applying plenty of tape to his legs and running the ladder drill. He's the smallest yet second oldest on the team and has been part of a human pyramid on water skis. He also loves baseball.
Bronco was did that too after his NHL career, except he was always the base.
Yes, I always was, especially my cheerleading career.
Looks like a cross-checking call coming up against the Oakland Junior Grizzlies. Going to have our first customer in the sin bin. That's going to be Max Jones, who gets sent to the Who Scout. Gets a chance to play that PlayStation 3, which, of course, is 50 cents for every 30 seconds. Hopefully, people got the memo. We'll take a look right here. There's a little bit of a hook there. I don't see the cross-check as the play comes in all right in front of the penalty boxes. And that may be the cross-check right there as he caught the player in the back. Number 14, it looked like Juszczyk getting the cross-check. He goes down in a heap. So, Max Jones gets a chance, as I said, play that PlayStation 3. Broncos supplied all the games. He brought them from his home, and he's donating that money that we make from our from our penalty box money so that we can save for the PlayStation 4.
I've changed my mind. I would rather save to get more food. So I think that's what we're going to do.
Get more food? You have five pizzas in front of you.
Well, I need a little bit more than that right now because I'm losing weight. I'm down to 395.
Okay, well, we wouldn't want that to happen.
No, I've got to keep my figure up.
There you see the chance earlier for the Oakland Junior Grizzlies as they nearly made it 2-0. Theo Harris with a nice shot there. 8:41 left to go in the first period of play as Max Jones visits the sin bin. So the Suburban Stars with a chance to tie with the man advantage. Max Jones wears the number 19 because his favorite player is Joe Sakic. Oh, my gosh, sacrilege. He has a brother, Mitch, that plays for Beltire AAA. He has a pet ferret named Mike. And his dad, the head coach, as we said, played in the NHL. Boncour loses his goalie stick. Merlini gives him his stick. He's out there with the little stick. Bronco is Merlini running around the ice without a stick right
now. Makes things a little difficult. He's just circling around trying to figure out how he's going to get his stick back.
Stars holding in the zone, looking for a chance while that goalie stick is lost, but Blankenberg will take it away and get it loose. He swings it ahead. Pass doesn't quite connect as it puts the Stars back deep in their own end. Carried around behind the cage by Grisicki.
Luke likes pizza and Dr. Pepper. his pregame habit, getting to the rink first before Austin and Tyler get there, and eating the energy bar his mom forces on him. He runs cross country, loves his iPod, and loves to have teammates over to play mini sticks and lacrosse in the driveway.
There's a long shot taken in by Blankenberg, steered aside by Applebaum. Is that stick still laying out there on the ice, I believe, as they continue to battle back and forth. Comes along the boards, moving up on the play is Vanderveen. And the Stars jump right in there to take it away once again. 21 battling for it. McCullough, that's pokey for your Stars. And as it'll be heaved back down the ice by the Junior Grizzlies. Still killing the penalty out there. And steered around the left wing side. As the Suburban Stars look to move it up out there on the ice, number 24, Joey Orr, the Mojo. And boy, he's got a famous hockey name.
Joey likes steak and cheeseburgers. Before the game, he drinks a lot of water and eats scrambled eggs. He likes to be early so he isn't rushed before the game, and he races dirt bikes and likes to snow ski, rollerblade, go boating, and play mini sticks with teammates. And he has a turtle named Squirt.
Puck sent it to net by Senske.
Knocked out of the air, score! Oh, man, he knocked that down. That goes in the net, fans, and we have our second goal of the first period.
Danny McCrail chopped that out of midair on the bounce, it looked like, and put it past Boncour. And we're tied up. The goal comes 7 seconds, I believe, after the completion of the power play. But take a look. Here's Anastas, who sent a shot as we were given some information on his teammate. Swept out of harm's way by Venuto. But as it came around the boards, it's stopped by Tyler Senske, the big man. And he fires this, takes a shot at the net here. And another stop, but the rebound comes up in the air. And it's knocked out of midair. Hard to see right there. Comes off an ankle. Squirts past the glove of Boncour as he tried to corral it. And the tying goal for Danny McCrail. It won't be a power play goal, but that's a biggie for your Suburban Stars, Bronco.
Yeah, it shows you their attitude of just coming back and evening things up quickly.
Take another look at it from up top. And Anastas took the original shot. That was fended off by Boncour, then swept around the boards by Venuto. But stepping up in front of the blue line is double zero, Tyler Senske. And Sense tees this one up, sends it. Got a little bit of a screen there. You get a deflect, actually deflected before it got to the goaltender. And then look at it, knocked out of midair. And it squirted through the defenseman and past Boncour's glove. Into the back of the cage. What a goal for your Suburban Stars, Bronco.
Yeah, very big goal. A very alert play with that thing pounding around up in the air, and he puts it in.
6:34 left to go in the first period of play. As we said, a couple of excellent Squirt AA hockey games, and we're all knotted back up at one apiece. As we face it off over the Hockey Town logo, tussling for it there. Junior Grizzlies trying to work it loose as they get it over to the near side for Levering. Here's Levering working in. Levering sends the shot right on, and Applebaum will squeeze it in the big mitt. Keep that from causing any further damage. He's got flames on his helmet, Bronco.
Yeah, a lot of creative work done on these goaltenders' helmets this year.
Another look, number 10, Savelle fights it loose, gets it to Levering, and Levering skates it in at the right wing side. A little stick handling here before he lets one fly at the top of the circle. The dipping shot, but Spencer Applebaum picks it off cleanly. Nice chance for Levering, and you got to watch when he's out on the ice. He actually likes to park himself out in front of that goaltender normally. Team describes him as a hard-nosed Thomas Holmstrom, Bronco.
That's a pretty good adjective to describe somebody. Great player.
Yeah, one of the best. As it's brought back across the blue line, here's Savelle! Right on. There's another shot that's lifted over the top of the net. Savelle digging for it in the corner. Stars move it up the boards, getting a stick on it there. Vanderveen. And Vanderveen, who snatched it away again, but it's pushed out to center ice as a couple of players meet over the Hockey Town logo. Sent back up the near side. Look out for Savelle. Savelle sends another shot right on. That's knocked down up by Applebaum and chopped out of there. They swing it back. There's a backhand shot. No, Applebaum looking to dive on it. And finally gets a whistle there. All kinds of pressure by the Oakland Junior Grizzlies. Joey Savelle with a couple of nice chances. Let's take a look back. The ice level replay as Savelle brings it in here initially and swings this shot from just beyond the faceoff dot. Coming up high, knocked away. But good job back on this blue line as Van Der Veen keeps it alive. That was deflected and kind of wobbles back in there. Bronco, they try and jam it through way out on the white ice. Is Spencer Applebaum trying to track it down and finally gets the whistle from the man with the orange armbands.
Yep, we have so many players around the net there. Here we go. Teamwork. You're absolutely right. Joey.
It's like imagine that's the Joey Savelle fan club up there. And Joey's wears number 10, and he's 10 years old. His favorite hockey player is Martin St. Louis on the Tampa Bay Lightning. He likes playing roller hockey as well. His 1997 Mission team has been national champions for 2 years running. And, of course, Bronco, his favorite food is French fries.
Oh, man, that's a great one.
It's the Suburban Stars getting some pressure, but the Oakland Junior Grizzlies will move it back out, flip it all the way across here to Theo Harris. Theo Harris looking to cut in on the play. Sends it on the backhand into the slot. It's pushed back to the point. Grizzlies moving it around out there. Backhand shot at the side of it. Look out, Applebaum out of position. Boy, he had to get back quickly, Bronco.
Yeah, to get the other side of that net because they were going to try another wraparound at the other end.
Oakland Junior Grizzlies working hard to get that lead back. They got all kinds of pressure going out there, Bronco.
Oh, they sure do. These teams are going to lean on each other all afternoon.
This one's tapped loose along the boards, and it'll be chased down. I believe this looks like Jones turning back up with it over the Hockey Town logo. He picks up some company. Tried to hop a stick there, but it's Suburban Stars. Move it back out to center ice. Number 14, Colin Juszczyk, the Spider-Man all over these Grizzlies out there. As it swung back into the Oakland Grizzlies zone, knocked off the boards. It'll be picked up by Savelle. There's Savelle, ooh, he picks up company with Anastas on his back. There's a backhand shot coming up high. Loose in the blue ice, and ooh, Applebaum gets it covered long enough to get the whistle. As some more pressure, Theo Harris in there with another chance. Let's take a look as we go down low. And Junior Grizzlies, Savelle picking this up, trying to send it on net, but he had a couple of Suburban Stars there to slow him down, knock him off the puck. And a nice backhand shot coming in high there. And look at Spencer Applebaum went up and got it, looked like off the net guard. Bounced off his defenseman, and he was able to get it covered. Spencer Applebaum making saves every which way he can, Bronco.
Absolutely, and he loves University of Michigan. Before the game, he closes his eyes and thinks psychologically about the game and what he's going to do. He has been playing the violin since age 4, plays outfield for the Cobras and loves playing video games, mini sticks, Guitar Hero, and ping pong tournament in his basement.
There's Boca, who looks like working it out here. And as he carried across the blue line, ends up knocked off the stick, shot toward the net. Junior Grizzlies get in front of that. Chopping at it is Merlini. Gets it loose back out through center ice. They try and feather a pass through. Nice job to jump in front of that by Blankenberg. His pass is intercepted, however. And here comes Senske. Senske tripped up as he tried to get across the blue line. Steal away.
Oh, here's nice
Savelle's. Takes a pass back. Oh, and misfiring. Blankenberg had the chance, Bronco.
Well, he sure had an excellent opportunity there and just missed.
Beautiful setup all the way down the ice. Comes Senske looking to center the send the pass to Marson, but it was tipped in on Boncour, who got it covered. And Boncour has been equal to the task down at his end of the ice, Bronco.
Well, Brendan Boncour is really fast. You'll notice that when he's in the net, how quick his response is to the play coming at him.
Look at this big chance for the Junior Grizzlies as Senske tried to work out with it. Tripped up a bit, it looked like Garrett Hall, but no penalty on the play. And then it's quickly rush as Dick Blankenberg picks it up, sends it over to Savelle. Savelle gives it back to him. Brackley's got the gun cocked, but he misfires, and didn't look like he got that on net, Bronco.
Nope, I think if he would have found the gap in there, he would have scored.
It's a face-off deep in the Grizzlies' end, knocked down out in front of the goaltender. Backhand shot comes on. It's steered off in behind the cage. Working out there is number 19, Dylan Jones. Jones trying to get it back. And at the Junior Grizzlies walling him off there as it's pushed back to center ice. This is going to run out of gas. No icing. As back to collect it goes Becker. Becker getting a stick on it. Becker looking to move through traffic, but it's knocked off of his stick by Levering. And it'll be sent back out to center ice. Look out. Dylan Jones catching up with the puck. He's got one defenseman back who steers him off to the corner. Merlini doing a nice job trying to send it out front. Couldn't get it there as it's pushed along the far boards. And we'll squirt back over the blue line. I believe that'll be offsides. And chance to slow things down just a moment. And get some more chance to see some of those signs up there. There's the
Bryce there.
Bryce Becker fan club, Mr. RPM on your Stars.
Bryce loves anything with sugar on it or that comes out of a bag of ribs. Oh, before the game, he likes two teaspoons of honey and fresh pink tape on his stick. He plays lacrosse and golf and taught himself to snowboard at the age of five by standing on a child's sled on a hill.
That's pretty strange. I never heard of anybody putting two teaspoons of honey on their stick.
I haven't either, and pink tape. Well, everybody's got their...
Wait a minute, maybe he has the two teaspoons of honey and the pink tape.
Oh, okay, yeah, you don't want to put that on your stick. Of course, the puck would stick right to it.
Well, your hands would stick to it, too.
Yeah.
It gets messy real fast, though. That's pushed in behind the cage. Stars looking to get something going here. It's shot off the side of the net. Big rebound, but it's swept out of there by the Grizzlies. Look out, moving
in. Fires again.
The shot. Look out. That bounces over the top of the back of the cage. Number 13, Betrell, gets a stick on it. As they jam in along the far boards, kicking at it is Betrell. And the Junior Grizzlies get it up to the blue line, but not out. They'll find an open side, though. Send it to the right wing. And right there on defense comes the double out by Sense again. Sensky, they're struggling for it right in front of the penalty boxes. Torn away here by number 15. As skates to the far circle is Anasta sending a backhand shot and scores!
He did. He kept right after it. He goes in and puts it in the net. What a great goal.
Drew with an unassisted goal with less than a minute to go here in this first period of play. Gives the Suburban Stars their first lead of the hockey game. As they're trying to work it out of the corner here. And it looks like Anastas finally gets it on the tape, tears it away from a couple of Junior Grizzlies, and he goes from one side of the ice to another to set up his backhander, Bronco.
Absolutely, what a dazzling play.
Using the long reach and sends it from a tough angle and squeezes it through the five hole before Brendan can shut it down.
Yeah, there wasn't a lot of room in there either. And he managed to put that in.
We have a big look at the... We just got that shot of the goal in time before our official interrupt us there, Bronco.
Yeah, sometimes they tend to get in the way of our camera crew.
Take another look at it from up top. An unassisted goal for Drew Anastas. Took it away from a couple Junior Grizzlies. Used his reach, held it away, peeled it back away from the defense. And then from a tough angle there, squeezed it through the five hole, Bronco.
Yeah, beautiful goal. Amazing.
Big goal there for Drew as the Suburban Stars go up on top 2-1 in this hockey game with 52.4 seconds left in the frame. And Bronco will tell you a little bit about Drew that you might not know.
Drew likes animal crackers and Dr. Pepper. He's the fastest undresser. He's out of the locker room and drinking a Slurpee before anyone else is undressed. He plays basketball. His sister scored the winning goal in double overtime in a state championship game.
So it's a whole family of hockey players, it sounds like. Fastest undresser, huh, Bronco?
Yep, that's quite an honor.
Well, Bronco, he's a fast undresser because actually the only thing he ever wears is Speedos, so how hard is that?
Well, there's a lot of elastic in him. It takes a big tug to get them babies
that's
off.
True. He's not the first one in the locker room, though, because they have to wait for the Zamboni to pull him out from between the pipes. There's a shot right on. Right on the doorstep was Marson trying to tip it through. But Brendan Boncourt caught up with it, ended up inside the goalie pads, it looked like. Got caught up in the equipment. And Brendan's been doing an excellent job. He's actually a fifth grader, but he's also the first string goaltender on a sixth grade lacrosse team, Bronco.
Well, that shows the great athleticism of the young man. I wonder if he's smarter than a fifth grader.
Well, hopefully he's at least as smart as a fifth grader.
Yeah, that's right.
That's what you hope for, because since he is a fifth grader. Maybe he's as smart as a sixth grader.
He might be if he's playing on that sixth grade team.
I know I'm not smarter than a fifth grader. I've tried the home version of that game a few times. I never can get to the $1 million.
Well, I guess not, because when you were in the fifth grade, electricity was just invented.
Yeah, well, and if you were in the fifth grade, they were still on the horse and buggies.
Those are the good old days.
That'll do it for the first period of play, but we had a penalty right here at the end of the period against your Stars. And we'll see if we can pick it up here. Went to number 21, Kyle McCullough. There's he stuck the stick out there, and I think he tripped up number 19, Max Jones, on the play before the final horn went, Branko.
Yep, you can see the referee making the call. And there are some young ladies really getting into this.
Oh, they're going to love the chicken dance. She usually comes up at the end of the second.
Yeah, that looks like those old go-go dancers, doesn't it?
Get down tonight. She's doing the monkey up there.
Yeah, it sure is.
Well, I'll put a fresh 12 minutes up there. You see the penalty up on the board to number 21, Kyle McCullough. So the Oakland Junior Grizzlies will have a power play. Here's Branko to bring you all the first period stats.
Okay, let's take a look at game stats after one period of play. Shots on goal, the Junior Grizzlies with 11, the Stars with 8. Faceoffs won. Well, look at that, sports fans. That's exactly even. It's 6 for each team. Now take a look at your quality scoring chances. Oakland with 4, Suburban Stars with 3, and your power play percentages. Grizzlies were 0-0, and the Stars were 0-1. A great matchup because these teams are so aggressive.
And now it's time to have a little fun there, hockey fans. Hopefully we haven't shown you this puzzle in the past, but there's your Hall of Famer. We're playing Name the Hall of Famer. That's the visual clue. That's all you get. We'll let you give you a few clues to his identity. First of all, it's not a three-legged hockey player. He was the first to ever score 50 goals in a single season with the Detroit Red Wings, and he also does have a Stanley Cup ring, however, not with the Detroit Red Wings. That's all I'm going to give you right now. Second part of the trick is you got to find us here at the Joe Louis Arena. They don't allow us in the regular play-by-play booth. If you find us with the correct answer, Bronco's got a great prize for 2008.
Our prize for this year is a great one. A cruise on a barge. Large on the barge, folks. For all you hefty folks, we have a great game, and that's a limbo contest where the pole doesn't go lower than 5 feet. I'll be there, of course, supervising with my Speedos on. We have your all-you-can-eat buffet that's served on the deck. We'll feature pickled pig's feet, octopi, barnacle buns, and bread with lard. After this, we're going to have a breakdancing contest where the idea is to break everything in sight.
Michael's very good at that. All he has to do is move a little bit.
Oh, my goodness. I'll tell you, eating pizza's a religion, and this is the holy day of obligation. I'm going to get right in that front row, fans. It's Little Caesar's Pizza.
Branko's going to go down and raid the PlayStation 3 coin box before the game's even over.
I'm on my way right now.
You only got a couple of dollars there right now. You need another 50 cents to get yourself a slice. So.
Oh, man.
You'll have to wait a little bit. As we're underway here, second period of play, as the Junior Grizzlies working on a power play here. We'll work it into the Suburban Star zone, push it in behind the cage. Swung back out to the slot. There's no shot there. They'll move it around the point. Tried to throw it back in, but the Stars got in front of that and are able to send it back out through center ice. As that's dumped all the way back down. Double nickels, Blake Avenue picking it up. He'll throw it ahead. Blake Avenue, boy, he's a radical one on this team. He's a second-degree black belt, two-time regional wrestling champion in his weight class, and this is his first year playing defense in hockey, though, Branko.
What a great athlete, but great wrestler. Maybe one day he can wrestle The Undertaker on TV.
Yeah, that's right. Branko used to be a professional wrestler himself.
Well, I was sumo wrestling.
Oh, okay.
I could wear my Speedos then. They basically look just like
that's
those.
That's when he started wearing Speedos, and they were so comfortable. Now that's all he ever wears.
Yeah, sometimes I put a tie on with him.
Lots of times at these championship games, he'll come down to center ice and model different pair for the people.
Yeah, I might do that again. A lot of people have asked me to come and do that again.
As this is swept around the near side, jamming into the play of the Grizzlies, trying to hold it in, but the Star is able to push it back down the ice. Flannery couldn't keep it in. And back to collect it. There's number 33, William Van Der Veen. He sends it to the right side. Long pass back to the near side here for Hall. Hall, he's dangerous. Got one goal in his
nice
game. Look
skating,
out, one
nice
goal there.
Skating.
There's a shot, and he scores!
Oh, man, he spanked that baby.
He ripped that through the glove of Spencer Applebaum, his second goal of the contest, and he gets the Junior Grizzlies back even, Bronco.
What a contest here today. Two great aggressive teams going at it.
Take another look as number 11, Nick Blankenberg, will pick up an assist along with 33, William Vanderveen, and he just fired that one, Bronco.
That he sure did.
Shot that one. What was that on the timer?
Well, let's see here. Let me hit the buttons here. 102.3 miles an hour on that puck.
Well, not much way that Applebaum was going to catch up with that one. As a beautiful play working down the ice. A power play goal for your Oakland Junior Grizzlies as they moved it up the ice nicely, Bronco.
Yeah, nice pass to him.
As 33 throwing a pass up to him. That was William Vanderveen getting it started. Was number 11, as you see, a kind of handcuffed Applebaum right through the glove, Bronco.
That was so quick, a lot of velocity like that. It's hard to track those down.
Well, we all already gave you the information on Garrett Hall. Yeah, let's get a little information on William Vanderveen, who made the nice pass to get that play going. 10:32 left to go in the second. We're all tied up on the power play goal. A little bit about Vanderveen. He attends Bemis Elementary in Troy along with his teammate Tommy Theo Harris. And when he's not, doesn't have blades on his feet, he's got wheels because he enjoys skateboarding and rollerblading. And his favorite hockey player is Nicholas Lindstrom. It's nice to have all this press kit information so we can get to know the players a little bit more up close and personal. As now the star is trying to work down along the near side is Petrell. Petrell gets it into the zone. He'll continue on, works into the corner with it, looking out front with it, swings it back for
fires,
number 25,
shot right on,
ooh. Is Kyle McCullough had the gun cocked, Bronco.
He sure did fire a rocket at him.
As he's out of the penalty box and looking to get the goal back here. The Grizzlies picked up while he had to sit down for a couple of minutes. Keep that blade on the ice and good things will happen, as it was McCullough, Pokey, who got it back. Pushed it back off into the corner, and a nice pass swung out front right there by number 13, giving it back. Petrell gives it back to Pokey, who whistled one at the short side, but Brendan Boncour was there to make the stop. As the Suburban Stars work a nice chance, as we certainly are getting our money's worth here in this Squirt AA Championship contest, Bronco.
Yeah, they're just very entertaining teams to watch.
Faceoff taken by the Stars, trying to drop it back to the point, but it's taken away here by number 13. Connor Jean working down. He gets back checked, swings it to the slot, and that's picked off. As picking it up will be Tyler Senske. Look out. Sense getting it rolling up the ice. Sense works around the man. Sense a shot, scores!
Goodness gracious. That guy is so big and strong, and man, when he fires it, what can you do about it?
Well, that banged from one side of the net to the other, pinballed off the post, I believe, as it ended up in the back of the cage. There's a huge goal right there. We've got an assist on this one to Danny McGrail. He helped get it started, deflected off of his stick, I believe, right to Tyler Senske, and he just wound and fired, and boy, did he rip a missile at Brendan Boncour, Bronco.
Yeah, that thing could have even went through the net with that kind of force.
I tell you, sense is money, Bronco.
You better believe it. You want to talk about a big, powerful young man.
Is Mr. Double Zero getting it done for Suburban Stars as they regain the one-goal lead here. Take another look up top. As there's the pass right there coming from number 10, Danny McCrail. I somehow didn't notice that earlier, but he just gave it back to Senske, who had the full set of steam going. Sense works around the defense and fires this. It looked like it might have come off the glove of Boncour, but boy, did he rip that shot, Bronco.
Yeah, he left no doubt in his mind. He knew right away that he was going to just launch that.
These Squirt AA players probably can't wait until they get to Pee Wee and they can throw the slap shots and the body checks out there. But less than a minute after the Junior Grizzlies even it up, the Stars go back on top with the goal from Senske. Now 3-2 lead for your Suburban Stars with 9:48 left in the second period of play. As we'll square it off over the Hockey Town logo again. The fans are going crazy. Boy, do we have a good game going on here. Off along the far side, Dylan Jones works it in for the Stars. Stars tried to push in was Eric Marson, but Ick was stopped.
Eric Marson likes mac and cheese. Before the game, he likes to relax, and he likes to sing in the locker room and will someday marry Hannah Montana. better known as Miley Cyrus.
18 backhands it into the slot. That's Connor Inger, but right back come your Stars again looking for more. Knocked off the stick of Ick as it goes back off into the corner. Fighting over there is Blake Avenue. It's sent back out through center ice. It'll drift through the neutral zone, but Nick Boca getting a stick on it. Backhands it along the boards. It'll be pushed deep into the Junior Grizzlies end, but we'll get a whistle.
Nick Boca loves his donuts and Mountain Dew. He eats Snickers and drinks Mountain Dew and listens to his iPod before the game. He has attended U of M games at Yost Arena. He's a straight-A student, plays baseball and football, and is most influenced by his dad.
And that stoppage in play was because it was flipped up over the boards, but the fans right there to hand it back to the man with the striped shirt. As the Grizzlies will win the faceoff. Push in front of the penalty boxes, and that'll be tapped in the zone. Couple of players getting tangled up, and both go down. Worked into the corner by the Junior Grizzlies. It looks like we're going to get a call here. It looks like a holding call, and it's going to go against the Stars. I believe this is going to be number 5 RPM, Bryce Becker. So he's going to have to sit at 0 RPM for a couple minutes or less there, Bronco.
Yeah, he sure is. He's going to have a seat and wait to get back out.
Pick it up. He got tangled up with number 87, Garrett Hall, who's already got a couple of goals in this game, and took him out on the play. And I'm not sure if that's where the penalty came, but I believe so. As it's touched up by the Stars in the corner, the arm is up. So Eagles gets a chance to play his favorite game. It might be Pizza Pong or Cake Mania or Feeding Frenzy that Broncos got there.
All great food-related games.
You got Fast Food food Tycoon as well. You build your own fast food chain. With 8:44 left to go in the second period, we'll see if the Junior Grizzlies can even it back up on a power play, Bronco.
Oh, they certainly are up to it. This is a back-and-forth seesaw battle.
They evened it once on the power play to start this second period of play, and then the Stars came right back with the goal. Well, now they'll have to take a stab at it again as Savelle picks up the puck. Sends it to the right side, but that's blocked off. Ooh, trying to work in it with it is Juszczyk. Juszczyk killing the penalty. He'll steer it back in behind the cage.
Well, Juszczyk likes the University of Michigan, and he has his Mountain Dew is his favorite food. Best friends with number 10 and plays with a lot of intensity. Explodes off the bench. Shows up at practice wearing a lot of ties.
Okay.
More than one at a time?
I used to get all of my ties from Value Village because they had all those wacky ties that you could find there.
Yep, 50 cents each.
Look out, there's a little collision there as the Grizzlies come away with it. Nice pass ahead here for Hall. Hall tapped off of his stick. Good defense. Senske made that look easy as it's sent right back down the ice on Boncour. Boncour will leave it to the side of the net for Marino Merlini. And Marino Merlini, boy, he's a hard-working defenseman out there for this Junior Grizzlies team. Oh, he's got to try and stop this one, but getting the shot off, backhand shot, swept right back on him. Boncour with a couple of huge saves as Eric Marson broke in with a couple of chances, Bronco.
Oh, they were all around the blue ice, and Boncour was alert.
Take a look here as it's worked back out through center ice, but Marson picks it up. And Marlini tried to knock it off his stick, but he's got the shot away right on Boncour. Then came right back with a backhand shot. And look at the right pad save for Brendan Boncour, Bronco.
Yeah, good photo op for Brandon.
Marson nearly made it the two-goal lead for the Suburban Stars on a shorthanded chance there. And good goaltending by Boncour to... keep that from spoiling the party, Bronco.
Yeah, he's been great all season. We're seeing why here today.
That's number 21 right there as he sends a shot at the side of the net. Kyle McCullough has been dangerous out there for his Stars.
Kyle likes the University of Michigan. Before the game, he always sits in the same spot in the locker room next to the same players. Always the last one out of the locker room after a skate, and the teammates enjoy his wild haircuts.
Well, we might see what that looks like during the award ceremony then.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to now after his teammates
say
that.
After they go and tell us that, we'll have to look forward and check that out. as it's fought out of the zone. Oh, couple players tangled up again. Dylan Jones going down with one of the Junior Grizzlies. He's tried to race up the right wing side. Looks like Dylan Jones going to pay the price on it, Branko.
Yep, there goes Mr. Jones skating off for a seat.
And, so this will give the Oakland Junior Grizzlies a few seconds of a 5-on-3 opportunity. And is breaking up ice with it. I believe that's Connor Jean right there. And Jones basically on the takedown, Branko.
Yeah, you can see the body sprawled on the ice. The Mr. Referee calls it.
Both go sliding across the ice as the whistle goes. That may have been, that's number 12, Tommy Theo Harris, I believe. And so 8 seconds of a 5-on-3, it'll turn basically into a long power play opportunity for the Junior Grizzlies, Branko, and the Stars don't want to go to this well too often.
No, you don't want to do that. It's difficult to stop this over and over again.
Working it in.
No!
Says the shot scores!
Immediately it's fired in, fans!
Theo Harris fires as he took it out of the faceoff circle, crossed into the zone, and he baffled Applebaum with the shot as the first penalty had just expired. And but the player not really back into the play yet as he crosses in here, lines up the shot as he waits and very patient on the play. Broncos sent a rising shot at Spencer Applebaum, who thought he had it in the glove, but it ended up in the back of the net instead.
Yeah, you could see how he took his time, lined his shot up, didn't rush to do it, and put it in.
And we'll have to take another look at that one from up top. As there you see through the faceoff circle, Applebaum using his body, played keep away there from Betrell, spun around, tied Betrell up in knots, and then he leans back on one, Branko, fires between the two defensemen, and it eluded the trapper of Spencer Applebaum as it got into the back of the cage. And we're all knotted up here again on the power play goal for the Oakland Junior Grizzlies. Is 3-3 with 6:43 left to go here in the second. Theo Harris is one of the four original players left on this team. His favorite players are Alexander Ovechkin and Chris Chelios. And he likes Chelios because he's Greek like Tommy. And he's a fifth grader at Bemis Elementary. He also likes to rollerblade and play golf when he's not playing hockey. His favorite movie's Miracles. Favorite food's pasta. And he wants to go to Harvard when he grows up and become a lawyer, Branko.
Well, that's a good ambition. Harvard, one of the best law schools in the country and the world.
Oh,
there's
lost
somebody.
Some fans.
He's enjoying the competition here today.
I think he's waiting for the next game.
Get up.
Kensington Valley Renegades or Rebels.
That's what it looks like. Get up. Quickly. Get up. Well, I can't wake him up there. I was going to holler louder, but I'll let him sleep.
Well, we're back underway once again. Is that power play goal from Tommy Theo Harris was huge, oh so huge, Branko.
You better believe it was.
Theo Harris still out there as it's tapped back behind the net. It got up the way, other way, Suburban Stars. McGrail was trying to get away. He'll send it deep into the zone, but may have been offsides as we're going to get a whistle to stop the action. We'll get some new, fresh legs out there for everyone.
There's somebody. Move the noisemaker.
Now, that's not the same kid that was sleeping, is it?
I don't know, but look at the balloon right there. I can't even see the person behind it.
I think they are waiting for the next game because that's definitely Kensington Valley colors coming in here. So that they're watching a good one while they wait, Branko.
No, they sure are. A lot of people have come in from the lobby area to see this. They've heard how great of a contest this is.
Levering as they try and muscle him off the puck. Ooh, and he's got big number 77, Grosicki, landing right on top of him. Mr. Fat Force, you don't really want him. That's almost as bad as Branko landing on top of you. Handling the puck back there in deep, or trying to establish position out front there. Number 18, Connor Inger out there. Boy, we got a whole book on Connor Inger. He just turned 11 on March 4th, and he's looking forward to spring hockey. He also plays baseball and golf. One of the things he's looking forward to in spring hockey is being able to add checking into his game, Branko. And he plans on going to vacation. One thing he's very excited about is this rematch down here at Joe Louis Arena with the same team they played last year, but he's hoping the outcome will be a lot different. Ah, that tells me now I know which team won it last year, Branko.
Oh, yeah, that's been given away.
And it was the Suburban Stars. And unfortunately, like I said, I can't remember the name of the teams that they were last year, but I know the name of both teams were entirely different. is he'll work this one in. Ooh, chopped at there, and a little bouncing the player off the goaltender as they didn't like that last little chop by Max Jones, Bronco.
Yeah, they didn't like that, and you're going to defend your goaltender.
Jones looking for a penalty, but he's not going to get one as Austin Betrell, the A-train, as you said, Bronco, just defending his goaltender out there. Who, by the way, is Sam Wasnicki now for the Suburban Stars as they send a shot at him out of the faceoff circle.
Well, old Sam, he likes spinach and pierogies. He loves U of M. Before the game, he likes petting both of his dogs three times. He loves to golf and skateboard with his grandpa. I mean, I have grandpa that skateboards. That's pretty good. Loves his dogs, too. Has a brother that plays with the brothers of Kyle, Nick, and Colin on the 99 Stars.
A shot that was sent in on Brendan Boncour. Just stuck the glove out and made the easy stab here, Bronco.
Yeah, he makes it look easy.
That one's fired in. I believe that's Joey Orr, the mojo, looking for some mojo. But you'll have to do better than that to beat the double B in between the pipes, Bronco.
Yep, absolutely. He always gets congratulations from his team. He's got a lot of support.
Nick Blankenberg, one of the smallest players out there, but he plays tough for these Oakland Junior Grizzlies. In fact, his team says he plays like the biggest kid out on the ice, Bronco.
Yeah, well, I guess so, with that kind of speed and tenacity.
He got an older brother that plays for Bell Tire's AAA team, and his father also manages a AAA team. So, I would imagine with him on AA now, it might not be long before you see Nick Blankenberg playing AAA hockey, Bronco.
Yep, it'll be fun to cover one of those games for him.
Right now, there's still a job ahead of them as they're looking for a double-A championship. I didn't know it also, but looking at number 18 Inger's information earlier, the Oakland Junior Grizzlies were your international Silver Sticks champion, Bronco.
That's quite an honor right there. That's a tough workout for them, but they're good.
Look out, here come the Junior Grizzlies with a shot right on, working all the way down ice for the chance there. Robbie Flannery got loose and put the shot on Wasnicki, who had to come up with a sterling save again for his Stars, Bronco.
Oh, absolutely, and he's been a jewel in the net all year.
Look at a stoppage in play here. It looked like the play might have popped across the line offside. As Robbie Flannery nearly gave his Oakland Junior Grizzlies the lead as he broke loose and came all the way down the ice with it. See, as he swats it away from the Suburban Stars, gets the legs churning up ice, Bronco.
Yeah, you can see him coming at you right here. We'll slow it down a little bit, but he's open there to fire that in. He gets real close here and nails it in there, but the goaltender again.
Right from the hash marks, but in good position. Sam Wasnicki closed the door on him.
Sudden Sam.
Robbie Flannery is an outgoing 10-year-old. He's in the fifth grade at Rogers Elementary, where he excels academically, and he's one of the four original players from the inception of the hockey club, which now I remember, now they tell me, it's Cranks Hockey Club. That's who was here last year. I think the Suburban Stars were a Farmington team, either the Fire or the Flames, and he also likes playing, when he's not playing hockey, he can be found practicing WWE moves with his little brother Danny. I wonder if Danny volunteers for that or not, Bronco.
I don't know. Some of those wrestling moves are kind of wicked.
We'll get another whistle as the play comes in offsides. Now, I couldn't think of it. It was Cranks Hockey Club, and I believe the Suburban Stars were one of our Farmington Hills clubs. But
goal!
Hockey member, I imagine that's a fan club for Austin Elger, I imagine. Wearing the number 8 on the chest anyway. As 21 working in here as McCullough ends up pushed in behind the cage. He'll come back to the near corner. Getting in there to chop at it as the A-train as he tries to dig it loose for his Stars.
Well, he likes grilled cheese and tiramisu cake. Pre-game, getting to the rink first before Luke Krasicki, and at least 1 hour early, would be 2 hours if Mom would let him. Likes to play mini sticks with his teammates. Loves 95.5 radio.
Look out, here's a chance working down. Oh, and getting a piece of it, Boncour, as there was the A train. Took a nice pass from the Krasicki, Bronco.
Yeah, that was just a beautiful play.
Yes, it was a 2-on-0 chance, basically, and Suburban Stars couldn't find a way to get it past Boncour. I wonder if you, on the Cake Mania game in the penalty box, if you can make a tiramisu
miso cake or whatever that's called.
I've never had that, but they can always send us a piece.
Yeah, well, Bronco will sample if it's got if it's a cake.
Yes,
he'll at
I
least
like
give it a sample.
Anything that has, I love cake.
Is here you see this chance coming down. Luke Grosicki, actually, it was a 2-on-1 chance here as Venuto is back on defense, tried to sweep it off the stick, but a nice pass put it right there for Austin Petrell. Had time to line up his shot, but getting a piece of it with the glove was Boncour, Bronco.
That's all Boncour had to do was get that piece and deflect it out of the way.
Got enough of it to steer it wide. Beautiful chance coming down for your Stars. They'll hold it inside the zone. Move it around as Anastas into the corner. He's being watched closely. They try and send it back to the point, but it's intercepted. Long pass to the open wing on the right side. Look out, having a little trouble with it was Senski. But he got back to dig it loose. Carried in by Juszczyk. Knocked off of his stick. Back on the play comes Levering. He gets hammered along the boards, it looked like there, but no penalty coming. Spin on move as Becker works back in from the slot. He was surrounded by Grizzlies. That's a scary thing, being surrounded by Grizzlies.
Yeah, especially if they're growling.
Those Kodiak Grizzlies. We saw those. I saw that in that movie. I'll be scared of them now the rest of my life. The Edge or whatever that was called.
Oh, I remember that movie. That was really a good one.
He's pushed back down the ice by the Stars. Collected it in his own zone. Turned around behind his own net is Merlini. Merlini's got an older brother that plays in the IHL for the Port Huron Ice Dogs, Bronco. And he's described as a very caring and loving person with a heart of gold. And he's always driven to excellence. He's got great abilities. Look out, here's a shot. Oh, bounces in there, and Boncour takes care of that. He's very big on his family and friends, Bronco.
Yep, teamwork's important here, number 10.
Marino Merlini. Isn't playing hockey. He likes to fish and ride trail bikes. I'm a big lover of fishing myself. I like to get out there and do some bass fishing. When I retire from this, I'd love to be on the Bass Masters Circuit, Bronco.
Oh, that'd be fun, a professional fisherman. Yeah. What does a fisherman do on his day off?
That
put a sign up
question,
that says gone fishing?
I could work for a living as a fisherman and fish on my days off. That would be, what a life that would be.
Yep, that's one of those perfect occupations.
Maybe I'll call Marino, see if he wants to buy a fishing boat together. We can get it done.
Right, that sounds good to me.
Of course, he'll have to put up the money.
Yeah, well, yeah, he has to. We'll do the fishing.
Because I certainly don't have any.
I'll do the eating.
Yeah, well, there we go. Well, you'll have to clean them, too, then.
All right, that's all right. Sometimes you just eat them raw.
Scales and all, eh?
That's right. Sushi bluegill.
This is pushed back into the Suburban Star Zone, but it pops all the way back out through center ice. Chopping at it along the far boards, Marson. Back to collect it goes Blankenberg again. As it will be picked up by the Grizzlies. Grizzlies break out right side. Coming down ice with it is Savelle. And Savelle can't work it in close as he was walled off by Boca. Comes off to the near corner. And that's going to do it for period number two as the blue light comes on as we remain even. Now a 3-3 score between your Oakland Junior Grizzlies and Suburban Stars, Bronco.
Yep, absolutely. A classic matchup, a barn burner, a cliffhanger here at the Joe Louis Arena this afternoon.
They'll put 12 more minutes on the board for period number three, but meanwhile, Bronco will update you on all the game stats.
So how even are your game stats? Let's check them out and see. Shots on goal, the Stars with 18, the Grizzlies with 16. Faceoffs won, Suburban Stars with 16. Oakland Junior Grizzlies with 13. Quality scoring chances, 8 for the Stars, 7 for the Grizzlies. And your power play percentages, the Grizzlies were 2-for-3, which is good. And power plays for the Stars were 0-for-1 so far, and we still haven't decided anything. All we've seen is fantastic, creative hockey, and it's very even.
And don't forget, be hunting us down here at the Joe Louis Arena with the correct answer to our Hall of Famer question. As we said, we're not allowed in the regular play-by-play booth, not since Bronco and the sauerkraut incident. You've probably heard of that before, but folks, never put sauerkraut in a microwave in a tin pan because the aftermath is just too horrible to even describe. There's your visual clue again. Not a three-legged hockey player. First to score 50 goals in a single season with the Detroit Red Wings. And the dead giveaway clue here is he's fond of letting all people in the Detroit area know that the hockey rink is no place to be biting your fingernails or any other nervous habits. hunt us down and get on that large barge.
I just came up with another one of my great ideas.
That's why I have so many gray hairs.
Well, this is a classic. I'm going to select someone from either the Oakland team or the Suburban team, and I'm going to invite myself over for dinner right after the hockey game. That's right.
Someone that owns a grocery store.
Well, there's got to be a lot of food in some of these houses. I'm going to try to guess which person would have the most food.
Well, to fill you up, you'll have to go to all of the houses.
That's not a bad idea. We'll think about that for next year.
Well, there you see all those championship banners hanging up in the rafters here at the JLA Bronco.
Do they have more than the Detroit Lions?
Just a couple, I think.
Yeah, I'm trying to think about the Lions.
Actually,
had four world champions.
More than all the other major sports combined.
I think even if you had the Pistons, they might be just about the same amount all combined.
Maybe if you had the Shock, they might tie them.
Yeah, but the Shock.
Hoping to add another one this year, of course.
Yep, they just might do that.
You know, one of these teams hoping for a championship trophy here today as we're knotted up at three in a good hockey game. Underway here again, third period of play. Shot is blocked as they try and blow it through Senske. That isn't going to work. Off along the corner. They'll push it over to number 13, the A-Train. Sends, dangerous pass up the middle, Bronco. Don't want to try that too often.
Yeah, that's a coach's nightmare.
Especially with Grizzlies lurking everywhere. As this goes back into the corner, picked up here by the junior Grizzlies. Try to bounce pass off the boards as Connor Jean will find it. He sends a centering pass and he dribbles. Oh, hey, look out here. Chance breaking in with a hold and drifted off the stick on Jones before he could snap the backhander. But I think he had some help there, Bronco.
Yeah, I think so, too. I think we're going to have a penalty called on that play.
It'll be a tripping call against Bryce Becker. And this is Bryce's second trip to the sin bin. He might have a Cake Mania game or something he wants to finish, Bronco.
Yeah, he doesn't want to sit there on that bench right now, that hard bench, when he wants to get out there. Dude, this is all for all the marbles.
We'll see. Breaking in your junior Grizzlies there. There's the stick. Tap the puck away, but tripping up. Number 19, I believe that is. Max Jones taking the hard tumble, Bronco.
Yep.
That almost looked like that Bobby Orr picture that we have on another one of our Hall of Famer puzzles.
Yeah, a lot of these guys, they just hit the ice and bounce right back up again.
So this is Oakland Junior Grizzlies with a big break here to start the third period of play as they'll go on the power play and see if they can get the lead back in this one, Bronco.
Yep, it's a seesaw battle right now, and we're just starting from scratch, folks.
Anastas couldn't work it out. Look out, Zavell trying to work it through. Backhand shot toward the net as Blankenberg sent it, but it was blocked off. And they'll find the seam in between the points to get it back out through neutral ice there, Bronco.
Yep, we're going to see this go on and on and on here, back and forth, end-to-end action.
Blankenberg picking it back up. He peels back, makes a nice pass to Zavell. Oh, pass across. Oh, they try to get it back to Zavell. Shot! And Wozniacki stretched out and got a piece of that, Bronco.
Yeah, he sure did. Hot Sam.
Played with a high stick, but it's waved off as the Stars pick it up, and they'll send it all the way back down. And Boncor, who will put the paw over the top of it. But the Stars, they had their number 10 right on the doorstep. That's Danny McGrail. There you get a good look at Sam Wozniacki.
Yep, there he is, Super Sam.
Doing a little groundskeeping here at the other end of the ice as we get set to face it off to the right side of Boncor. Out there is Colin Juszczyk at center as he wins the faceoff, but he lost the edge, went down, and the Grizzlies pick it up and move it down the ice. All the way into the zone is Evanew. Evanew is walled off as he couldn't squeeze through along the near side, but hold it in, getting the stick on it there is Hall. Stars take it right back away. Number 8 will flink, get it back out to center ice. That's double A Austin Alger working hard for his Stars.
Austin loves hamburgers, pizza, and chicken fingers. He likes to crack jokes in the locker room before the game, and he can do a Crosby shot move at full speed. Has bowled 192 and enjoys baseball, lacrosse, basketball, and bowling.
Look out! Chances the Grizzlies work all the way back down on the play. Elger had a chance at the other end, and it's the junior Grizzlies right back, and that's what we've had in this contest, Bronco. Good back-and-forth action.
Yeah, both teams, like I say, have been very aggressive, and that makes for entertaining, exciting hockey.
Here's Garrett Hall, the pass, shot right on. Wozniacki coming up big.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, bang, bang, play as Savelle was set up beautifully by Hall, Bronco. Those two have worked great together out in this game.
They never seem to tire.
As they've got two of the three junior Grizzlies goals, trying to sweep it in, lay it down. That shot was wide. As well, man, from one end to another we go, Bronco.
Yep, the people are on their feet here. A lot of people have not even sat down since the opening of this contest.
And just after the Stars kill their penalty, they're going to go on the power play as we're going to have a tripping call against the Junior Grizzlies. Let's see who was caught here. I believe it's number 11, Nick Blankenberger. Let's see if we can pick it up. As there's double zero going down, tried to sweep it in from laying down right there, and the shot whistled wide, and I don't know how they missed that, Bronco. Looked like they up and open net, and there's Blankenberg got tangled up with, I believe that's Marson over there, and he picked up the penalty call. So the Suburban Stars will get their chance to see if they can grab the advantage, Bronco.
That's what they want right now, and Oakland has to stop it.
A little earlier before the penalty, however, it was a big chance here for the Oakland Junior Grizzlies as the Garrett Hall working out there with Joey Savelle, and they nearly broke the 3-3 deadlock with this play, Bronco.
Yeah, we'll slow it down so you can watch every move.
There you see a beautiful pass wide open as Joey. He sends the rising shot. Looked like a blocker stop for Wozniacki. Rebound was there, but so were the Stars, and Senske was there, the big man, to clear it away for his Stars. 9:13 left to go in the third period of play, and hang on to your hats. Now it's the Stars' turn with the man advantage. Faceoff will be deep in the Junior Grizzlies' end to the right side of Boncourt. Out at center is McCullough for your Stars. As it's pushed into the faceoff circle, and they'll heave this all the way down the ice as it goes to the far corner. Floats in behind the goaltender. Back to get it come your Stars looking for an opening here. And the Grizzlies converge on them to slow things down, but they'll find an open space to the right side as they'll be pushed into the Junior Grizzlies' end. Right back out, however, and sending the Stars chasing back behind Wozniacki once again. Grizzlies are on it there in a hurry, though. Look out, trying to get the shot out front. There's a shot. Rebound shot ripped right on. Number 19.
It's still loose. That puck is still out there.
Max Jones still fighting for the shorthanded chance, and the Stars finally able to wrest it away, push it up for Orr. He has it now.
Oh, man.
Coming right back in. Connor Inger was looking for it, but Wozniacki wasn't going to give him a chance, Bronco.
No, Super Sam dives out.
Look at this work out there by Max Jones. As he stick handles it out front, snaps the shot. Wozniacki made that save, then the second save here. Max Jones just stayed with it, Bronco. The Stars couldn't work it off of his stick. That shot will hit the side of the net before finally number 77, Grzycki, able to clear the garbage out for his Stars. And a good shorthanded opportunity out there for these Oakland Junior Grizzlies. They'll send it back out on net. And this time, Wozniacki said, I'm not going through that again. Face off to his right side. It's pushed up the near side, swung across the zone. They'll snap it right back, trying to get it to Avenue. And the Stars come up with it and clear it down the ice. As Merlini out there trying to chop it off the stick and get some help levering, coming back on the play. And Asta's trying to turn with it. And nice job to hold it in the zone there by Becker. He sends it at the cage, but Merlini will lift it. Looks like he came off the top of somebody's helmet. And look out, here's Levering breaking in.
Levering!
Up for the net. Ooh, tried to make the pass to Savelle, couldn't quite connect on it. And back into the corner it goes, swung around the far side by Becker. And on it is McGrail. McGrail will send the long pass to the left side, a little out in front of Juszczyk, but he'll catch up with it. Juszczyk! Oh, he wanted to fling it inside that post and missed it wide, Bronco.
Yep, missed it just a little bit wide.
It's pushed back up to the blue line, sent through the slot, off into the corner it goes. Battling in there is Vanderveen. Vanderveen playing keep away from the Stars as it'll be picked up by Joey Zavell again. Boy, Joey's putting in a lot of ice time for his coach out there. As it's tapped off of his stick, and Marson will turn with it, send it for Senske a little bit behind him, but he'll swing the shot right on, and Boncourt will freeze it quickly, Bronco.
Yep, Brendan Boncourt doing a great job today.
Good look at the big man here as he'll come off for a break. We'll get some changes in personnel out there for both these squirt AA squads. tap on the head there for Tyler Senske. His sense has played a good game for his team, Bracco.
Yep, he shows a lot of sense.
Thank you very much. Yeah, it don't get any better, folks, so you might as well laugh now. This is pushed back into the corner. Slung up the boards. The Stars fighting to hold it in. You see number 7, Jack Venuto, out there. He's a great stay-at-home defenseman for these Oakland Junior Grizzlies. And the coaches say about him that you always know you're going to get 110% when Jack's on the ice. There's a shot! That might have hit the crossbar!
Oh, my goodness gracious, that's the beauty of this game.
Got past Wasnicki as Venuto will chase it down again. As we said about Venuto, boy, he comes to play every night. That's what the coach is saying. You know what you're going to get when he's out on the ice.
And I know
it's maximum effort, I'm sure.
100% in every game.
We may have another penalty coming. I'm not sure what they whistled down there. We'll see if we can pick it up. I believe we've got possibly an interference call coming here. But let's take a look back here at some more of the action from down low. Bracco is number 19. It looks like, again, Maximum Jones working out there for his Oakland Junior Grizzlies as he sends the pass all the way across here, and a good chance, and it came off the post, Bracco.
Yeah, a game of inches, and you saw that.
Beat the Wasnicki past the glove, but banged it off the post, and it stayed out of there. As the Suburban Stars caught a break on that play, Bracco.
Yeah, they sure did. We still haven't decided anything yet.
Off to the corner to collect it goes Becker. Becker moves it to the right side as the Suburban Stars will break back out. And Estes lost it in the skates, had to turn around for it. Back out on the ice, Blankenberg steers it away from him. And he'll be pushed back through center ice for Blankenberg. Blankenberg sends the pass for Hall. Hall trying to work through. Senske knocks it off his stick. And it's pushed up the boards and back across the blue line as Merlini drops it back for Savelle once again. Savelle he must have boundless energy, Bronco, because the coach is keeping him out there quite a long time.
Well, he doesn't tire, and the coach realizes how hard he's practiced all year, and it's paying off today.
Here comes the Spider-Man. He's walled off. Gets this tough angle shot off, though, from the circle there. Driven back all the way to the boards there and still got a good shot away, Bronco.
Yeah, he sure did.
Here's a look at the Oakland Junior Grizzlies working in again. As we said, Savelle putting in a lot of ice time, but Anastas was right there to stop him up. And then back the other way goes number 14 on the play, Colin Juszczyk. And I believe that's where the penalty was in there, was with Joey Savelle getting tangled up with Anastas. 5:27 left to go here in the third period of play. And the Suburban Stars will get another chance with that power play, Bracco.
Yeah, and you know the next goal could win this, and you don't think that's on the minds of these coaches and players? Think again.
Trying to set up out front out there. Looks like big Dylan Jones. He's being watched closely, and he's dangerous for the Stars team.
Well, Dylan Jones likes soft tacos and root beer. One of the favorite things he likes to do before the pregame is to look good for the ladies. He also plays football, baseball, golf, swims, and skis. A man of all sports. He likes the Boston College Eagles.
We got so much more time before you have to start worrying about looking good for the ladies. Yeah, he's going to be the ladies' man. Huh? Look out! Backhand shot, and Boncourt looked like he got a piece of that. As Marson just swatted that backhander, Bracco.
Yep, they're going to try from all angles. They're going to try all the shots right now because we're getting down to real crunch time.
Long shot sent in by Senske, and that was just steered aside by Boncourt. Off to the far wall. As the Grizzlies get on it, it'll be tapped across the red line by Blankenberg. As the defense for the Stars chases back, they'll send a long pass ahead once again. But the Grizzlies are there to stop it at the blue line, but Stars keep coming, Bronco.
Yep, the Stars are coming out tonight.
Grizzlies playing solid defense out there on this penalty kill and able to slow things down. Merlini has to try a second time. Just did get it past Juszczyk, who nearly stopped it on the blue line. And the Stars push the Grizzlies back into their own end. Grizzlies will get it working up ice here. They'll get tangled up. Number 19 out there, Max Jones working hard. Look out, as here comes Juszczyk sending the shot. And it looked like Boncour may have got a piece of that with the glove. This will be sent back out through center ice. And once again, back to get it goes Senski. Makes a nice pass ahead here for Juszczyk. Juszczyk trying to hold off the Grizzlies, and they both go tumbling through the end line. The man with the orange armband took a hard look at it, Bronco.
Yeah, and he shook his head. He wasn't going to call it.
Here comes number 10 down the ice again, Savelle. Savelle working through a crowd. Oh, and they picked his pocket as the A-train was there at the last second, Bronco.
Yeah, absolutely, and the people are on their feet here today. There's a lot of noise in the arena.
It's a great rematch going on here. And the Junior Grizzlies, the Cranks Hockey Club last year, hoping to change the fortunes in this one. They're working awful hard. But the Suburban Stars matching them stride for stride gets frozen up against the boards. We'll get a whistle to stop the action. As one of the players may have landed on the puck. Somebody getting up slowly here. Looked like levering.
My goodness, I love hockey.
You're looking at the pizza slice.
I know it there. I saw that little box of pizza there, and I was ready to go see if I could have a pepperoni off it.
Looks like that young lady was handing out some Stars jewelry out there, Brian.
Yeah, to get me one of them necklaces. Probably be so tight on me, I'd choke.
Yeah, I'll have to put an extra chain on it, I guess. This is sent to the far side. After it goes Alger. Alger has it poked off his stick. Double A out there with Dylan Jones once again. And here come the Grizzlies. That loft. Oh, it's Ephus pitch coming in there on Woznicki, and he had to play shortstop, Bronco.
Sometimes those are real dangerous. You don't know what's going to happen if it bounces in front of you.
Yeah, you want to get it before it has a chance to short hop on you.
Yep, a good shot of your goaltender.
If it short hops that close to the goaltender, could go off in any direction. Faceoff will be to the right side of Sam. Won by the Stars to the boards, and getting at the stick on it there is Hall. It's held in at the blue line, sent to the faceoff circle. They'll try the other side this time as they find the opening. Nice job is racing up here with it. Oh, number 14 tangled up again. Juszczyk gets it out front. Oh, and that was nearly deflected in the cage by the Grizzlies coming back on the play. And just did end up wide. Here's right back come your Grizzlies, number 87, Hall. Hall has picked up a shadow now in this game, Bronco. They're jumping all over him as soon as he touches the puck. This is pushed back as Flannery goes in behind the cage to pick it up. Flannery taking a look up ice. He'll send it to the right side. Dangerous, but Blankenberg was waiting there and poked it back out to the neutral zone. As Senski couldn't work through with it. Stars trying to find a way to pick their way through traffic here, right in front of the two benches. Dump back into the Grizzlies' end. His second effort will get it back out to the neutral zone once again. Trying to turn right back in with it, or lost his edge, or he might have been gone. And here's a beautiful pass ahead right here. Oh, look out, chance! Oh, and they try to shovel it through. And Woznicki able to make the stop as, Joey Savelle coming up a little bit lame as he went as hard as he could, Bronco. And he crashed hard into those boards.
He sure did. He's a little hurting right now here. We're going to slow things up here, and some of the players are gathered around him.
He went right over the top of Woznicki as he tried to get in there and poke it into the cage. As you see right here, take a look at some of this action. Is a nice pass ahead. I believe that's Blankenberg making the pass. As Zafel picked it up in stride, got it between the legs of Senski, and then he goes for it on the other side. As Woznicki was trying to make the poke check, and right over the top of him when Joey Savelle slammed into those boards behind him. 1:07 left to go in the third period of play, Bronco, and we're about down to the time where the next goal probably wins.
Well, this is really great hockey here, fans. No 7-1 score, 8-2. It's for everything, and it's even.
This is lofted back out to neutral ice as clearing the zone with Senski. Right back, looking to come right back. Number 12, he's got a goal in this game, Theo Harris, but he couldn't muscle his way through. Look out for Senski. He's also scored in this contest. He's a big man. Throws it through the lip of the blue ice, but nobody there to ram it home for the Stars. Pushing it back deep was Alger. He'll battle for it in behind the cage. Look out! Comes out front, but he does a backhand shot.
Front again.
Grizzlies were all over that, and nobody could get
another
a stick
shot.
On. Oh, couldn't get the shot off it as it came off the stick. And Theo Harris able to clear it back out.
We have a breakaway here.
There's a chance. Shot ripped in high, knocked away by Wozniacki off to the corner. Steered around the near boards as time ticking away. Holding it in will be Vanderveen. But the Stars trying to muscle it out of their 77. Krasicki got some help. And the Stars coming right back looking for a chance. Not going to get one, though, as he was held off nicely by Merlini. It's the Grizzlies to work it back up, trying for one more rush up the ice. Send the long shot as the blue-white comes on, right on target. And Wozniacki had to cover it. As we're going to OT, Bronco, in this one.
Well, you almost figured this was going to happen. You know, it doesn't get any better than this, and it's so fitting for two teams that have had magical seasons to face off in an overtime competition here this afternoon.
This young lady's happy about it as she's holding up her sign. She's ready for more. That's the Tyler Senske fan club up there, Bronco. They're rocking and rolling.
Yep, having a good time here this afternoon. 3 minutes.
Now we'll go 4-on-4 in period number 4. 3-on-3 if we need another one. And if nobody scores, we got to go to a shootout. But here's Bronco to give you our stats through regulation in this one.
Okay, fans, after three complete periods of play, shots on goal, the Grizzlies with 24, the Stars with 22, face-offs won, Suburban with 22, the Oakland Grizzlies with 19, and then look at your quality scoring chances, Grizzlies 11, Stars 10, power play percentages 2-for-4 for the Grizzlies, 0-for-3 for the Stars. And what can you say about one of the classic matchups that we've seen in the last 10 years? This is it.
And this is could be your chance to win that trip on the large barge. The cruise could end at any moment because we're into sudden death now. There's your Hall of Famer once again. You're looking at the blocked off pitcher. It's not a three-legged hockey player. First to score 50 goals in a single season in a Red Wings uniform. That might not be who you think. He's also picked up a Stanley Cup ring. That was with the Montreal Canadiens. And he's fond of letting all hockey fans know in the Detroit area that being at the hockey arena is no place to be biting your fingernails or any other nervous habits. You got to know who it is, so just hunt us down, and we'll get you in that on that large barge.
We're ready to go now with some real exciting hockey fans. And don't forget, I'm going to be selecting someone to come over to their house for dinner right after this contest ends today. And I'm really getting hungry. This overtime is increasing my appetite.
There goes the grocery budget for the month. There you see all those retired numbers up there. And if you think it's one of those retired numbers that you should be looking for, you're wrong. Including my favorite numbers up there, the latest one. That of longtime captain Stevie Eisenman. We're off and running with overtime. Look out, chance shot. Oh, and it goes over the top of the net. Picking it up is Garrett Hall trying to work in with it, but it's taken away and swung out through center ice by Anastas. Right back come the Grizzlies, however, as this will be pushed in behind the cage. Back there, the Stars get a stick on it, dump it around to the corner. First on it is Krasicki. Krasicki gets it loose, but as it's carried back out by Garrett Hall, he'll push it back in and jump it in front to as the Stars will wall that off. Push it around the near side here. A couple of players with the blades crossed here fighting for that puck. And it's fought loose here by McGrail. As he'll send it deep into the Grizzlies' end. In behind the cage, picked up here by Flannery. Flannery takes a look up ice, sends it off the boards on the left wing side to the open wing. The Stars are going to catch up with it first. Look out, that's not going to get out of here. Is in the face-off circle, sends into the slot, bounces back to the blue line, ripped wide as Merlini tried his luck right there and couldn't get the shot on net. Turned back around here by Hall. Hall moving out front, sends a shot, scores!
Scores!
Hall completes the hat trick with an assist again to Joey Savelle, and the Oakland Junior Grizzlies get their revenge, Bracco, in overtime here at the Joe Louis Arena.
And there's a lot of bedlam in here now as the equipment flies. Everybody's congratulating each other on the bench. What a matchup here today.
It's a whole bunch of Grizzlies who are having themselves a good time. The equipment goes flying everywhere as the Oakland Junior Grizzlies get it done. Here's Merlini. He sends the shot. That ends up wide. Tracking it down is Juszczyk. Juszczyk tries to steer up ice with it, but getting a piece of it right there, number 10, that's where he picks up an assist. Joey Savelle, and then watch Garrett Hall do the rest as he gets the hat trick, the biggest goal of the three right here as he fires one through the five hole on Wasnicki. Game over. Oakland Junior Grizzlies win it 4-3 in overtime.
What a classic we've seen here this afternoon. Two great combatants going at it.
Worth one more look from up top as Merlini sent it in and sent it in deep. Number 14, Juszczyk, trying to skate out of there with it, but he misfires as he tried to send the pass ahead to McCullough. Right back with it come the Junior Grizzlies, and Garrett Hall, what a goal scorer he is. He's got stars on him and manages to get the shot off and beat Wasnicki right down the middle, Bronco.
Oh, yeah, you talk about happy right now. Look at the expression on his face.
With 1:43 left to go in the overtime, the Oakland Junior Grizzlies get it done and win the Squirt AA Norris Championship 4-3. Here's Bronco with your final stats.
Wow, slow up and catch your breath, fans. Shots on goal, the Grizzlies with 25, the Stars with 22, Faceoff Swan Stars with 22, Grizzlies with 20, and your quality scoring chances, Oakland with 12, Suburban with 10, and your power play percentages, the Grizzlies were 2-for-4, and the Stars were 0-for-3 in a great matchup, and I think everybody'd like to see these teams go at it again and again and again.
Well, now it's time to reveal our Hall of Famer for today. A lot of fathers found us, but they knew nothing about our Hall of Famer question. I guess they weren't paying attention. We were in my favorite spot here in Newman's dressing room. That's where I like to hang out, until they start enforcing that restraining order. There's your visual clue once again. Not a three-legged hockey player. I think you probably would have figured that out, although it sure looks like one. He was the first to score 50 goals in a single season for the Detroit Red Wings, and it's not Gordie Howe, and it wasn't Stevie Eiserman either. He also did pick up a Stanley Cup ring with the Montreal Canadiens, and of course he's fond of letting all Detroit hockey fans know that the Ice Arena is no place to be a nervous person, because it's none other than your color commentator for the Detroit Red Wings, Mickey Redman.
Yep, what a great player he was in his day, and what a great asset he is to the community and to the Red Wing hockey organization. Nothing but a class act right there, ladies and gentlemen.
One of the great ones for the Detroit Red Wings has been your color commentator for, I don't know, it's got to be 20-plus years now, I think. Yes, he's had a couple of play-by-play partners, but he's still getting the job done for us. And now we're going to get the job done back on the Joe Louis ice, and we're going to hand out some championship hardware. Yes, some excited fans out there, Bronco. Is the Grizzlies fans holding up those signs. But first up are your Suburban Stars. 0-0, what a great game for Tyler Senske. Sense picking up a goal out there today. And a great job between the pipes for Spencer Applebaum as well. Senske also picked up an assist in this game. Number 3, Nick Boca, a hard-working defenseman out there. And number 4, Eric Marson Ick with a great game. Number 5, Bryce Becker. Number 8, Austin Alger. Boy, I don't have time to say much. Tanny McGrail with an excellent game with a goal and assist out there today. And you've got number 13, Austin Petrell, the A-train. Nice job for him. Colin Juszczyk, the Spider-Man, picked up an assist in today's contest. And Drew Anastas, who picked up a goal for his Suburban Stars as well. One of your big men, Dylan Jones, and a hard worker out there, Kyle McCullough. And 24 all over that ice, Joey Orr, the Mojo. And Sam Wasnicki did a great job in those pipes. And then you've got Luke Rosicki, the fat forest boy. He was out there doing a great job in those corners for this team. And we're giving out MVPs on both sides today. That MVP trophy supplied by Little Bill's Trophies. And it's going to go to, to Tyler Senske. Sets the big man. I think they announced that he's not sure that it's going to him, but it is. And why not, Bronco? Because he sure played a great game out there today.
You talk about powerful young man. There he is.
And as they get out the sponsor's trophy for the Suburban Stars, your head coach once again for the Stars is Joe Jones, helped out by Gary Becker, Tom Anastas, and Michael McCullough. Also Kevin Alger, and the great manager combination of Susan Buttrell and Terry Grosicki. What an excellent season for the Suburban Stars. A happy hockey club. They left it all out on the ice there today. Now let's get you reintroduced to your Squirt AA Norris champions, the Oakland Junior Grizzlies, and Brendan Boncour. Absolutely spectacular between those pipes today for the Junior Grizzlies. Following him up, Joe Venuto, and Joe playing hard defense all game long. Austin Levering, who had some great chances out there. Joey Savelle, what a great game, picked up two assists. Nick Blankenberg picking up an assist as well. Number 12, Tommy Theo Harris, was on go all game. He picked up the only goal that Garrett Hall didn't get. Fine job out there by Connor Jean and Connor Inger as well. Number 19, a hard worker, Max Jones. Boy, he had his opportunities. 24 out there, Marino Merlini. Great job in the defensive effort out there for these Junior Grizzlies. William Vanderveen, another hardworking member of that defensive core, picked up an assist. Robbie Flannery, all kinds of speed at that defensive position. And double nickels, Blake Avenue. Boy, he's doing a great job along those boards. I might saw a couple of karate chops out there. And Garrett Hall with the hat trick and the game winner today. And he's got to be right at the top of the list for possible MVP honors in this one, Bronco.
Yeah, hold your breath. Let's see who they pick here. They're still thinking it over. They should be calling a name at any moment.
The envelope, please, out there is there. You see the coaching staff and the team. Head coach is Brad Jones, helped out by Rob Flannery, Andrew Boncour, and Joe Savelle. And your manager, Rick Merlini. And it is going to be number 87. Winger Garrett Hall, who picks up three goals in this championship game, leads his Oakland Junior Grizzlies to victory, Bronco.
Yeah, what a great season he's had, and a game here today he'll never forget.
That's right. Put that one on the mantelpiece and have it stay there forever. There's the sponsor's trophy. The heck with the captain. Everybody wants this one, Bronco.
Yeah, this is what you work for all year. They're all going to get a touch on it, and the fans are on their feet from both teams applauding this contest here this afternoon. A classic, classic matchup.
One of the greatest hockey games you'll ever see. It's apropos that it's here right at Hockey Central, Hockey Town, the Joe Louis Arena. They'll take the victory lap pose for pictures, but it's our cue to wrap it up here. Our final score in overtime, the Oakland Junior Grizzlies win it 4-3 over the Suburban Star, and they are your Little Caesars 2008 Squirt AA Norris champions. But remember, ladies and gentlemen, it's not whether you win or lose here on Play-By-Play. It's how you play the game. For Play-By-Play, I have been Rance Ford.
And this is Bronco Bobby Wawa, and I've selected my winner, Austin Botrell. I'm coming over to your house for grilled cheese and tiramisu cake. Have plenty of cake. I'm on my way, baby.